You got a leakage problem there, bro.
Look at that rig imprint.
You got a leak.
It's all my fat cells crying because I'm beating them up.
How's it going? I'm Sheamus, aka the Celtic Warrior, and welcome to Celtic Warrior Workouts. We're here today in Greensboro, North Carolina at Strive Performance and Fitness. And if I'm going to be honest with you, right, I feel like I've bitten off a little bit more than I can chew, because we're going to be working out with the 2011 North American Strongest Man and the 2012 Arnold Amateur World Strongman Champion. Oh, and he's also been WWE Universal Champion, WWE Intercontinental Champion, and of course, WWE Raw Tag Team Champion. I'm talking about today's workout is with the monster among men, the one, the only. Give it up for Braun Strowman. How are you, Braun?
Man, what an introduction for one. Thanks, brother.
Oh my God. I feel like that's going to be harder than the workout, mate. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it only took you, what, 82 takes?
82 takes. Well, 81 and a half. When you came into WWE, I remember people like, holy what were you, 100 pounds heavier than what you are now?
Almost. I was 405 pounds when I started with WWE.
Like, so. I remember him walking out. I mean, if everyone does the hair and all, the mad hair and the singlet and like, I mean, like, it was incredible. Like that Wyatt, like the whole thing with the Wyatt family, unbelievable.
Very special times. I mean, when I think back about it, like they're still some of my happiest memories. Like with Brody and stuff like that, and the guys teaching me the ways and showing me. That, yeah, I was this green kid that didn't know the difference between my butt and my headlock. I debuted on Monday Night Raw after SummerSlam in 2015. I'd had 5 matches my entire life. So to be able to travel around with those guys and learn from 3 of the best guys, in my opinion, to ever step foot in the ring, like having those guys take me under their wing, I learned so much, and it was such a valuable time in my career that now being here going on, you know, being almost a decade working with WWE, like stepping out and thinking about all how amazing my career has been. Like you said, it's just been one unbelievable blessing after another, and I have to take these steps back from reality sometimes and be like, is this real?
Your whole workout has changed, right?
A lot. Dramatically a lot, yeah. So I'd gotten in the gym at an earlier age because of I was an overweight kid and I was severely bullied for it. And I thought if I could get into shape, well, I could get people to stop bullying me and stuff like that, which was a big truth, because it started to give me self-confidence, and I learned a lot by my trials and tribulations through the gym. You know, always finding solace in it, because the gym is the only place, in my opinion, that the weights will never lie to you. They'll tell you when you're having a bad day because they won't let you pick them up. They'll tell you when you're having a good day because they will. And it's one of the only things in my life that I've found that has that purity to it, where you know what you're getting when you go in.
How does Braun Strowman change from being this big, mass, bleeding Hulk dude to this bleeding, shredded man who looks like he's carried out of marble? That's what we're going to find out today, right?
Well, we're going to have to step out here to where the weights are, and okay, we're going to get a massive monster shoulder pump in a day. So a lot of we talked about the transitioning from strongman into the wrestling world. Now same thing with my training, has transitioned a lot. I do a lot more bodybuilding style training because it's easier on the joints. Like with the miles that I have with pressing 400 pounds over my head, I've squatted over 900 pounds, I've deadlifted over 1,000 pounds, and it's just wear and tear, because the human body's not meant to do that. But we're such crazy creatures that we want to test ourselves and push ourselves, and that was what I loved about strongman. It was just like, how far can the human body go? And it's now with me with wrestling, being 6'8" and 335 pounds now that I weigh, or when I was bigger, being able to go out there and do stuff that people go, that guy should not be able to do that at that size. And that's what I think has been so awesome, that I'd be able to sprinkle that in, because I can do everything. Let's be real. I ain't got no problem patting myself on the back. You name it, I can probably do it.
We know.
But at the same time, like what you talked about with the people that I've worked with and been around and learning the business, working with you, working with other guys that have been on the top of this mountain for so many times, and realizing what this is and how this business works and when to do stuff, how to do stuff, and why to do stuff.
All right, here we go. We'll talk.
I'm already sweating. Let's just say that beta alanine's got my skin tingling. Let's go move some weight around.
I should have worn my sunglasses with a top like that. All right, ready? Let's go do a bit.
I like to start with a little warm-up, so the shoulders with some internal rotation, external rotation. Sets of 10 to 15 internal, external rotation here. I think that's the proper term for it, I don't know. I'm a giant caveman. I just pick things up and put them down. And then the hair. Oh. Work all that rust out of them joints. And this is just with a lightweight. This is a 5-pound plate. You can do it with body weight, with bands, anything just to get some blood moving, get that stuff loosened up. I wish I would have done this when I was younger. I probably wouldn't be as sore and beat up as I am. But yeah, when I was younger, I just went in the gym and just started stacking plates, banging weights.
Stacking plates and banging weights.
That's how you become the monster of all monsters. All right, shoulders feel a little loose, let's go. We're gonna start with a dumbbell side lateral raises, 20-pound dumbbell, set of 20 for the first set. Key on these is you wanna pull through your elbows. So that really engages those lateral heads and stuff like that. Pulling through your elbows, making sure you're keeping your back upright. As you start to lean over, you start to hit more of your rear delt and stuff like that. So this really focuses on your lateral head or your delt. Go into these seated face pulls. Through the elbows here. Yep, right there. You want that. The palms to be lower than the elbows on the top. Yep. Go up the weight, go down to 15 reps.
I'm already hot.
Take it off. 2nd set.
I'm not cutting half the weight, right? I want to do it right. I don't want to show you up either, you know? I must have lost the tooth.
Yeah, don't knock your teeth out. You signed a waiver when you came here and said you were liable for your own injuries.
I promise I'll go up in the next set. I almost lost a tooth. Jeez.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
I'm heavier this time, right? Oh, that's tough. Come on. Hey.
Two more. Come on, one more.
I'm gonna try and probably stay the same way, because I don't want to just, for ego, trying to match him. I can't match him.
He's really heavy. It's like in and up. Yeah, perfect. Come on. Yeah. Look at that. You're already full.
Doesn't mean that.
All right. Now the worst part about all this is putting all the weights back. Don't be a D-bag. Put your weights away.
Yeah. Re-rack. Jack. Take a little bit of a breather here. What is your favorite cheat meal?
Probably a good cheeseburger, man. Like, in all honesty, a big 1 pound, yeah, 2 half-pound patties, some bacon, fried egg, avocado, some chipotle mayo. Screw the vegetables. On a nice, like, ciabatta bun, something like that.
Right.
I'm a burger man.
You're making me hungry, man.
What about you? What is yours?
Mine is
haggis? No, that's Scottish.
That's Scottish, yeah. No, you know what? I do love, one of my favorite things, but the whole thing since I came to America was a fried egg on any burger.
Yeah, there's something about
when you pop that
yolk.
That runny yolk, bro, and it goes all over. I can eat that all day.
Exercise number two is gonna be a superset with behind the neck presses. I'm real big on the behind the neck presses. They can be dangerous. So the big thing on that is not going past parallel. You wanna stop about right here, and this is your motion. Any of this back here, you're starting really pulling them joint, that joint where your rotator cuff, all that stuff meets in there. So we're gonna start on this. 20, 15, 12, 10, 8 again. And then we'll jump back and forth between the behind the neck presses and then upright rows on the Smith machine. Here on the upright rows, you can do your hands in multiple different positions. I like right about shoulder width apart. I feel like I get the best engagement in my front delt here. So on this upright row, this is your motion. We're hitting this front deltoid right here. So yeah, same thing about neutral shoulder width. Oh, this is an assisted Smith machine, so it actually helps you. So we gotta put more weight on. That feels good for 20. Fooled by the lightweight, this stuff adds up fast. This is all about forcing as much blood into the muscles as you can.
Since I'm a little shorter, let me just improvise.
Just need a couple extra inches, right?
We all do.
I'm good. I've been blessed with quite a few.
Here, right?
Yep. Right there, yep. Get good extension at the top though, full lockout. Breathe.
I forgot to breathe.
No, hold your breath.
I forgot to breathe.
I don't want to have to give you mouth to mouth, bring you back.
I don't want that
and
either.
I don't think you want that either.
Jesus, no. Shoulder width?
Shoulder width apart, a little more. You ain't as wide as me.
As I said, I'll have no ego at the end of this one.
Get that thing all the way up to the chin.
Jesus.
Nope, I'm Braun Strowman.
It's tough, man.
Come on. Power through, let's go. You invited me to do this.
No, I'm regretting it already.
That's very nice, yes?
This is what all of y'all came to see. Right there, yep, nice. Get that full lockout though. There it is, yeah.
Two more?
Nope.
12, right?
12. Okay. Baby got back. Freaking pump.
He's obviously working a lot harder than I am.
Oh, sorry, my butt sweat. Yeah, come on. 2, 3, 4, 9, 10. Come on, 2 more. 11, 12.
Feel great. Best I've felt in years.
2 more sets.
Okay.
Come on. I was just giving Sheamus a hard time about it's not a calf raise because as the weights, like I said, as we up the weights, it starts to get heavy, shoulders are starting to get full of blood, and he's giving himself a little momentum to get the weight started moving, which sometimes is necessary, but if you don't have to, don't do it. I'm a firm believer in, now in my older age, it's about lifting weights correctly so you don't injure yourself, you don't have nagging injuries, related stuff to that.
I got this, I'm a monster. I blow the roof off the place.
Blow the roof off the building, I blow the lid off the toilet. Banging weights, eating steaks. All right, enough of hobcockery, let's do this.
Come on!
God. You need me.
Come on!
Help me on these two.
I will. Come on. Push. Come on.
Yeah.
Oh, the pump's real. I just felt like 500 pounds.
Well, you've done about 7 million sets, mate. All right, you gotta give me a hand with this one, mate, please.
All right.
One, two. All right.
I'll start here.
Yeah. Oh, you got it?
Yep.
Come on, down a little bit more. Right there. Three. Four. One more. Watch your lips. Oh, baby.
Would you look at that? Would you just look at it? Look at that. Look at that. It's so full of blood. Look at that.
Awesome.
Oh, man.
Come on. Calf raises off.
Over your shoulders.
Come on.
Death by volume. We're hit all the major three heads of the delt, front, lateral, and now we're gonna hit the rear. It's important because this is how you get your full cap in here. You add the size in here. Wow. It gives you the shoulder, the bolder shoulder effect here. But it's also really important because those rear delts stabilize a lot more muscles you don't realize. When you're bench pressing, you're loading those rear delts in. Overhead pressing, they're used for stabilization of your front delt. A lot of that all ties into your lat, all that, so it's a really important small muscle group to really focus on, develop, and build strength around because it supports so many other of your bigger muscles that you use for your more important lifts.
See that? People just think he's a meathead. He's a bleeding scientist. The science detail in that, man. I'm blown away. You know what I mean?
All right,
four sets, right?
Yeah.
How many reps?
20. There he goes again.
I'm trying to teach people on this channel it's not about throwing heavy weights, it's about being
This isn't torn. Heavy!
Not for you it's not, because you're not bleeding human, are you? You're a bleeding alien. You know what I'm saying? Normal, regular people like myself.
You dropped it
99% of the world.
You dropped it 105 pounds?
Oh, wow. You're happy now, are you?
Oh, yeah, man.
All this right here.
Sheamus already has good shoulders, so like as you can see, this is gonna just add more mass if he keeps adding this in here. One day he can have shoulders like this.
205 pounds. That's ridiculous.
Now we can paint you a tan, man. You look like a bodybuilder.
Come on. Come on.
Get it back there.
Oh, 15.
Drop some weight and get 5 more. You owe me 5 more.
Sir, 20 more.
He is human after all.
Yeah.
sir. Yes, sir. Come on. Come on. Yes, sir. Good set. Good set.
The B man, you know? BS.
Yeah, I'm full of it.
Jesus. Come on. Killing it, man.
Oh,
all the way through?
That was 20. Well, 19 and a half. I'll give you one more. Watch out.
Negative there. Here, put that cleavage away, will you, for God's sake?
Can't help it, my milkshake brings all the boys to the yard.
Looks like you got stung by bees. Look how lumpy his body is.
Come on. Get him back there. Big squeeze. You're going to hate me in 2 days, but you're going to love me 3 days after that. Come on. I bet you thought that I was going to come in here and have all this crazy heavy weight and lift and all this stuff. You didn't know I was going to bury you in volume.
No, I knew it. I just didn't want to admit it.
That commences the rear delts. Now to the finisher. Are you ready for this?
I don't know. Are you going to carry me out of here if I'm not?
I mean, it's just like when we wrestle, right? I pretty much carry you through that.
Oh, Jesus. Jesus.
One of my absolute favorite machines on this earth is this little bad boy right here behind us. This Arsenal Strength. It's basically, you can do lateral raises, front raises with it. It really isolates the deltoid. And we're gonna do a 100 rep set to finish this off.
We're gonna go all the way through?
Yep, we're gonna go all the way through. We're gonna start on 70 pounds, do as many as we can do at 70. I'd love to be able to get 100 reps at 70, but I'm a realist, I'm not gonna be able to do that. So we're gonna drop the weight. I'm gonna get as many reps as I can with 70. I'll drop 10 pounds, get as many reps as I can with that, and keep going until I finish at 100. So every time I stop, I'll have Sheamus here pull the pin and drop it one plate. All right, it's time for the last set and the best set. Drop it.
No.
Three, 30. Drop it.
No.
40. Drop it 2.
Yeah.
50.
Start at 70. Work here. Keep going.
Oh, 60.
Oh, 10 pounds. That's it. That's it. I'm feeling it.
Oh, take a breather. That's 70.
Come on. Hurry up.
80.
You got this, fella.
Holy
I can help you, man. I can spot you in the end if you want. Let me know. Come on.
Oh.
Hurry up.
10 more.
All right. I can spot you. You want a spot?
No. You got 5 seconds of breathing. I got it. 1, 2.
Come on.
3. Oh.
Awesome, man.
And hold the last one. 1,
5, 6, 7, 8.
Now pain, no gain, right, Braun?
That ain't no joke. I haven't done that in a while. And I remember why I don't do it very often.
Scared of the Should I do 70 or less?
Nope, start with 70. All right, no, give me at least 10 with 70. 1, 2. Right, not that high, stop right parallel. There. 19, 20.
Last 10, come on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Get that last one up there. Hold it. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Oh, Jesus.
9, 10. We just finished the warm-up. You ready for your next exercise? I think you're gonna like it.
What?
Yeah. Ugh. Come on.
Come on.
No, don't hurt me,
Come on, I know you're tired. Just come here.
Can't take any more, man. I'm only human, fella, you know what I mean? Where we go, where you taking me?
Right here. I figured this would be fitting for you. Since you can't make it through the workout sets,
shoulders.
I'll leave you right here for these fine people at the Celtic Physical Therapy. I'm gonna go finish this workout. Good luck, champ.
Give him a second, he'll be out after you. Don't worry.
Oh, lock the door, don't let him in.